good afternoon, and thank you for coming out on the 23rd of December, when I'm sure you have other things you might like to be doing. First thing I want to say, as Victoria Matthews, Bishop of Christchurch, is a Merry Christmas to you all. We live in this city that continues to be reconstructed around us, and I just ask you this Christmas to again remember those who live in broken homes on the east side of the city, those who are still waiting for repairs to be completed. I also am going to ask you, because I have this opportunity, when you get home tonight, write in your calendar on the 24th or 25th of every month that it's time to do something for someone who is less than yourself. Every year at Christmas, there is an outpouring of generosity beyond belief, and I salute that. But this year, decide to do one step more and do it every 24th, 25th of the month, and do it for the sake of the birth of Christ. Now, the reason you're here is the building behind us. It's seen better days, so it's my delight to make this progress report on the way forward. The Anglican Diocese of Christchurch and the Church Property Trustees, also known as CPT, thank the government, Minister Brownlee, and the government-appointed independent consultant Miriam Dean, QC, for the report commissioned into the future of Christchurch Cathedral. The report outlines the options for reinstating the cathedral, as well as replacing it with a new contemporary building. Miriam Dean, QC, and her team did an excellent job assessing the positions of the parties involved and finding points of agreement. We are grateful for her hard work. The engineers and quantity surveyors involved were able to reach a large measure of high-level agreement on the engineering options and indicative costs of reinstating Christchurch Cathedral. The CPT are delighted to note that the report concurred with their engineers and quantity surveyors and confirmed the cost of reinstatement at $105 million. It also confirms that it's a complex and risky project. The report stated that reinstatement would require repair, restoration, and reconstruction. The engineers agreed that reinstatement could be completed by 2022. The Anglican Diocese of Christchurch and the Church Property Trustees wish to move past the current deadlock to find a way forward to reestablish a cathedral in Cathedral Square. We want to support the city to move forward, and we recognize the central importance of this building to many people in Christchurch. It's the calling of the church to minister to people, to serve the lost, the least, and the last. As the body of Christ, we use buildings, but we don't exist for the purpose, for the sake of bricks and mortar. Therefore, comprehensive measures to ensure safety during deconstruction and reinstatement, and measures to ensure future safety, including 100% of the new building standard, as well as sufficient financial resources, are essential. The Church Property Trustees will continue confidential conversations with the government about the challenges of safety and cost, which must be addressed before reinstatement can proceed through a new working group. Further announcements are expected at the end of April 2016.
Bishop, could I ask you why you won't commit to this reinstatement plan here and now?
Quite simply, right from the beginning, the Church has said we have two concerns. One is safety and one is cost. We couldn't commit to $105 million when we actually don't have anything remotely close to that.
Where would you think that money to come from?
That's part of the questions for the future. Come back at the end of April, and I'd love to think we have an answer.
Do you think the taxpayer might be running up with it?
I'm not the one to ask that.
What happens if there is no more money or if you can't find your way through?
Well, if you noticed, the Miriam Dean QC report mentioned also a contemporary build. So it would be a matter of looking at different possibilities if the money is not forthcoming. It could. On the other hand, I think every step of the way, we look at the possibilities. I don't think the Church would serve anyone well if we went out to try to raise $105 million when we live in a world with astounding need everywhere we look.
So are we any closer today to knowing what's going to happen?
We've made progress. I think the Miriam Dean report confirmed what CPT already knew, but I understand there wasn't perhaps the level of trust that we would have liked, and so that work has been done. Engineers have been talked to by Miriam Dean, who was lovely to work with, and she has come back and said the figures are correct, and we're now looking at what comes next.
The public are going to be disappointed that nothing's happened here today, though, aren't they?
Well, you see, the media was the one who said that this was going to be a decision. We actually never said that. So don't look at the people who didn't say something and then say we didn't deliver.
Minister, can I ask you if your government is prepared to put in some money to get this sorted?
Well, I think the most significant thing about the Miriam Dean work is that there is now a consensus among the engineers about the state of the cathedral and about the prospects and possibilities around reinstatement, including the extraordinary cost that's involved, actually, whichever way you look. So I see this as a very positive step. The Miriam Dean report is available for people to look at. We'll see what's in it. And over the next three months, we'll have another grouping looking at how you might move forward from this point. But you can't underestimate that very large sum of money, $105 million. There are various ways where that might be reduced, if, you know, speed of any activity or various other ways. But it really does, I think, challenge those who want to see the cathedral remain in a refurbished or restored state to come to the party with some of that fundraising. The government position is yet to be determined on that.
When will you determine that position?
Well, I think what I'm saying is that there is going to be a step-by-step process. At the moment, you asked the question before, why won't the Bishop commit to a plan? There is no plan. Until you had agreement among the engineers about what could happen and what the state of the cathedral was, you couldn't progress to a plan for a reinstatement. And so from this point up to the end of April, that will be determined.
Is April going to be the answer? In April, are we going to have a plan?
Well, I'd certainly hope that we have a great deal more clarity. Look, this is more clarity today. I know that some people have ramped it up. I've heard that various people in the media have had all sorts of tip-offs from all sorts of people. None of them have come from me, none of them have come from the Bishop, none of them have come from Miriam Dean. Where we're at today is announcing that there is agreement about the state of the cathedral. There is agreement about any proposal for reinstatement. Now, from that point, you need to have a plan that actually really does more specifically quantify the expense involved, the time involved, and the safety of the operation. And that's what we'll have in April.
How urgently do we need a decision on the cathedral?
Well, you know, I think the real point there is that it's been in this state since February 22nd, 2011. Another few months just working something out, I don't think hurts. I'd point out that there are people often tell me that cathedrals badly damaged in the Second World War have been successfully reinstated. I know that in one case it took 70 years for that to happen. So we're way ahead of that timeline.
Are you not worried that the other developments in the square are going to be held up?
No, I'm not. I think we're very close to a couple of other announcements that will be useful in that regard. And I think if in 3-4 months' time we've got clarity around this building, that's all part of a stepping in the right direction.
And what's the cost of a new build, building a new
cathedral? I believe that the Miriam Dean report put it at about $66 million.
Do you see that as still being a...
Well, some people would think that a $41 million difference is quite large. But that's why we've got to have that discussion. Sorry, there's a question over here. No, I can't give you that.
If replacement or reinstatement goes ahead, what role will the government play, if any?
Well, at the moment, the important thing is that the building belongs to the Church Property Trust. It is the property of the Anglican Church of New Zealand, or the Christchurch Diocese, in fact, I should say. Throughout this process, the government has tried to respect property rights as much as is possible, and we continue to do that. So we've played a role here of bringing together some disparate views to get a commonality of those views, and that's what we've achieved here, and I think that is a significant position to allow us to move forward.
To generate Christchurch, Cranco, would there be any official government role in any kind of project?
Well, let's see what comes out of the next few months, but this is, as the Bishop has acknowledged, a very significant building for Christchurch. The fact that there is a cathedral on the square is a significant landmark for Christchurch, and that's what we want to achieve in a workable way.
Would you like to see reinstatement?
I'd like to see the right decision made, and that will come at the end of the working party's best efforts.
We have two more minutes for questions.
What have the heritage groups had to say to you both about this?
I don't know.
Do you think that reinstatement is restoration in their eyes?
Look, I'm best not to make a comment about what the heritage people think. I really don't have a mindset that understands that.
Their engineers were involved, though, in consulting with Miriam Dean, is that right?
Look, I'm not aware of that. That was a completely independent exercise by Ms Dean, and there was no attempt by either the Church Property Trust or the government to affect a particular outcome. So I don't know who was consulted in that process. All right, can I just echo the Bishop's best wishes for a very Merry Christmas and all the best for 2016. Thank you very much.